Hello out there, myself Guru, and today's session is all about how the .NET compiles the code. If you have any queries or any doubts regarding this session, you can mail me on gurumatrix2004@gmail.com. If you have any queries, any doubts on this topic, you can just mail me or just ping me on gurumatrix2004@gmail.com. So let's start our session. Let me just open up the file now. So I will go to my E drive, freshers, test. Okay, so this image is nothing but it demonstrate how the .NET compiles the code. So yes, there are basically different languages on .NET. For example, C#, VB.NET, VC++, .NET, other languages like J#, COBOL, etc. So every language on .NET has its own compiler. For example, can you see a C# has got CSC.exe compiler. Likewise, VB.NET got VBC.exe compiler, and same way VC++ has got CLI.exe compiler. Okay, so when we write our code in C#, let's take an example of a C# now. When we write our source code, when a developer writes a source code in a C#, the CSE.exe compiler comes into the picture. It compiles the code into the half partially compiled code. Let me repeat this. When we write our code in C#, CSE.exe.compiler comes into the play and it takes the C# code, which is high level language, okay, and it converts into the partially half compiled code, which is nothing but MSL code. MSL code is nothing but, let me just write, that is Microsoft Intermediate Language Code, or simply we call it as IL code. So first C#, when we write our code in C#, it gets compiled by the CSE.exe into the MSIL code. Okay, so why it is half partially compiled code? Because when the CSE.exe compiler compiles the code, that is C# code, it doesn't know the environment. Okay, which environment it is going to run, which machine the code is going to run, or which environment the code is going to execute. Okay, that information, when the compiler converts the code into the MSL code, it is a platform independent. There is no specific platform instruction given when the compiler converts the code into the MSIL code. So that's why it's a half partially compiled code, that is MSIL code, that is IL code. So IL code is nothing but a half partially compiled code. Now this IL code, when it comes to the machine configuration, then CLR takes that IL code, that half partially compiled code, okay, takes that IL code and give it to the JIT. JIT is nothing but just in time compiler. Okay, now CLR. What is CLR means? It's a heart of .NET framework. The job of CLR is to handle, is to pass on the MSIL code to the JIT, and then it also maintains the garbage collection, automatic garbage collection happening. It clears the memory spaces. And code access security and code verification, it checks the code access, whether the code is proper or not, whether the code is not malicious, not harmful. It verifies the code and code provides the security to the code, And further the JIT. Now coming back to the JIT. Now JIT has got the MSIL code. JIT takes the MSIL code from the CLR. Okay, that is just in time compiler. Now JIT knows the platform specific instruction, it knows the environment, on which environment it should be executed. So depending upon the platform set of instruction, depending upon the machine configuration, the JIT compiles the half partially compiled code, that is MSIL code, into the full compilation. Full compilation means it platform specific instruction, it generates the binary code. Because the binary code is a low level language, and that low level language only the machine can understand, not the human being can understand. Okay, so that's the reason it JIT compiler converts that half partially compiled code into the binary code, that is according to the platform specific, according to the machine configuration, whatever machine configuration. For example, it might be a Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 7, or Windows Server 2003, you know, any platform specific instruction, it converts the half partially compiled code into the machine specific instruction. So at the end, our code executes on our machine, on our server, you know, anywhere. So this is how the overall .NET compiles the code. Let me just repeat this. C sharp, when we write our code in C sharp, CSE.exe compiler comes into the picture. It compiles the code into the half partially compiled code, that is nothing but IL code. IL code is nothing but Microsoft Intermediate Language code. Let me just show you how the Microsoft Intermediate Language code looks like, you know. So let me just open a test web application. Windows application. So it has been opening now, it's taking two time. Yeah. So basically it's a Windows Form application, it's a simple Windows Form application, it's got only one button, normal button, you know. When we click on that button, it only displays a simple message, that is hello, hello message, you know, it's a simple Windows Form application. Okay, as you can see that, go to the form design. Yes, just see, it got only one simple button, and on the button click I have written a simple message box dot show, that is hello. Let me just build this, let me just clean this first. Clean. I'm just showing how the .NET, how the IL code looks like. So build has been done. Let me just run this. Okay, hello. Yes. Now let me open up a tool called ILDASM tool. Okay, to open up the ILDASM tool, I will go to my Visual Studio 2010. I will go to my Visual Studio tools. I will click on the Visual Studio command prompt 2010. Remember, this command prompt is totally different from your normal command prompt, that is your XP or your 7 command prompt is totally different from Visual Studio command prompt. So here I am going to type, I am going to launch a tool, that is ILDASM tool. To launch the ILDASM tool, you need to simply type ILDASM and click on enter. So a tool will launch, you know. This demonstration is to see how the IL code looks like. So let me go to the my folder D drive. So test Windows application, Windows Form application. Go to the bin, debug, and let me just open up the Windows Form application 1.exe file, the exe of Windows Form application. So now let me go inside the Windows Form application dot form one. So I'm just, so now let me go into the button 1_.click. As you can see, this button click is similar to this button click. See this code. So as you can see, we can read the IL code with our naked eye. Means, see, this is IL code, the hello, which is similar to this hello. Message box dot show is hello. The value type is string. that is string here. So basically this is how the IL code looks like, means it's a half partially compiled code, you can read from your naked eye. Okay, so now let's go back to our image, that is that how the .NET compiles. So again, C sharp, when we write the code in the C sharp, CSC.exe compiler comes into the picture, it converts the C sharp code into the MSIL code, which is a half partially compiled code. And then common language runtime, which is the heart of .NET framework, it takes the MSIL code and pass it to the just-in-time compiler. Just-in-time compiler knows the platform specific instruction. As per the platform specific instruction, it compiles the code, half partial compiled code, into the full compilation. And finally we can execute our program. Remember, CLR is the heart of .NET framework. It consists of garbage collector, code access security, code verification, but it is also got some base class libraries, okay, which we can use in when we are developing our .NET application. So totally this is how the .NET compiles the code. So if you have any doubts or any queries, you know, you can mail me, that is gurumatrix2004@gmail.com. So thank you, thanks a lot.